नमस्कार दोस्तों, दिस इज किरण ठाकुर फ्रॉम आवर यूट्यूब चैनल एसेंशियल टिप्स। टुडे वी बैक विद अनदर वीडियो विद अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू। लेट मी जस्ट रिमाइंड यू गाइस दैट वी आर अपलोडिंग एवरी सिंगल क्वेश्चन विद इट आंसर दैट इज कम अक्रॉस इन आवर डे टू डे लाइफ। सो मेक श्योर टू सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल एंड नेवर फॉरगेट टू शेयर विद योर फ्रेंड सो दैट दे कैन ऑल्सो लर्न। वी ऑल लव टू प्ले इन वाटर एंड वेदर इट इज ऑन द पूल or it any oceans, we just can't get enough of playing in water. But have you ever noticed that we seem a weight less when we are in water? And we can move in a different sort of ways that is not possible in on land. So, and one thing have to be said that we seem to be like much more stronger when we are in water. That is, we can lift our friend that is are not so difficult. So, for that doubt, for that queries, we have considered these questions should be discussed here. And let's see what the questions are that we should be answered in this topic. So let's get started. Not only a Greek inventor but also a mathematician, an engineer, an astronomer who lived over 2000 years ago. One of the most famous discovery that he made was buoyancy. The discovery was quite interesting and let's see why it is quite interesting, we shall find out. The discovery was made while he was taking a bath. That is, when he stepped into the bath, he noticed that the water rise. The more of himself he put into the water, the more the water rise. For that reason, he realizing that what was happening at that point, and he allegedly jumped out of the tap and ran naked into the streets by shouting Eureka. So what does mean Eureka? If we translate from Greek to English, then it will be as I find out. No one knows for sure whether Archimedes really went sticking after making his discovery, or that is, his discovery was a scientific breakthrough, and that is often referred to as the famous Archimedes principle. Archimedes' discovery was the scientific principle of buoyancy, which holds that an object submerged in water will displace water. And that is how, that is according to how much it will going to weight. In fact, the water will push upward against the object with a force equal to the weight of the water that it displaces. How much water an object will displace will depend on its density, which is a measure of how much mass is in the object relative to its volume. For example, a bowling ball and a beach ball that are same in size, that will have the same volume, but the bowling ball, however, is more massive and thus denser than the beach ball. Can you guess what will happen if you drop both the bowling ball and the beach ball in the water? The bowling ball will sink and the beach ball will obviously float. And that is why. Let's find out. What will happen that in the both cases, the water will push up against the ball with a force equal to the weight of the water that is displaced. In the case of the bowling ball, it weighs more than the amount of water that it displaced, so it sinks. And what happened to beach ball is that it displaced very little water and the air inside it much lighter than the weight of the water it displaced. That is why it floats. In fact, we bet that We have experienced that the force of buoyancy for yourselves at one time or another. Have you ever played with a beach ball in the water? If your answer is yes, then you have probably tried to push it under the water. And what we have experienced is that the resistance we will feel when you try to push a beach ball under water, and that is the force of buoyancy at work. It is the same force of buoyancy that makes you seem super strong when we are in water. That is what the friend of ours who is so heavy on land seems a lot lighter in the water because of that buoyance. It's easier to lift our friend in water because the water itself pushes against our friend. Helping you lift him much easier than you could ever to do on land.